Quiet, please.
Anyone who has ever met or played against Yvonne Goolagong-Cawley will tell you the same thing. She is kind, self-effacing, down-to-earth, and played with such elegance that Martina Navratilova once said, "Yvonne didn't so much serve and volley as saunter and volley." Yvonne Goolagong-Cawley was also a trailblazer for her sport and her country. She won 14 Grand Slam titles, was ranked number one in the world, and has been awarded Australia's highest honours. And she achieved all this while breaking down barriers as an Indigenous woman, and then as the first mother to win Wimbledon in 66 years. This is the story of tennis's sunshine supergirl. Goolagong grew up in the small country town of Barilyn, in the wheat belt of rural New South Wales. The Goolagongs were the town's only Indigenous family, living a humble life on the outskirts of town. Dad, Kenneth, sheared sheep and fixed cars, and Mum, Melinda, mostly looked after their eight children. Money was scarce, and they lived in an era when Aboriginal people were anything but equal, and where Indigenous families were regularly split up by the authorities. Whenever a car would come down the road, my mum would tell us to hide, or else the welfare man would take you away, Goolagong told CNN in an interview in 2015. When Yvonne was 8 years old, she picked up a cartoon magazine and saw an article about an almost mythical, faraway place called Wimbledon. A kind auntie gave her a wooden bat, fashioned from an old fruit box, and she spent hours hitting a ball against a water tank on their property. Her mum even made her a tennis dress from some old bed sheets. Little Yvonne would stand and watch others playing at the local courts, her face pressed to the fence. One day, a keen local player, Bill Kurtzman, noticed her and asked if she wanted to join in. His small act of kindness would change Yvonne's life and tennis forever. From the moment a 19-year-old Goolagong arrived at Wimbledon in 1970, crowds fell in love with her elegant game style and relaxed, carefree approach to matches. Playing her was anything but relaxing, though, and she was soon breaking up the dominance of tennis's powerhouses, Margaret Court and Billie Jean King. Goolagong's first major singles title would come in 1971 at Roland Garros, when she was just 19. She remained the only female player in history to win the tournament on her debut. At Wimbledon, just a few weeks later, she beat King and Court in back-to-back matches to win her first title at SW19 in a victory that was seen and celebrated around the world. But prejudice was never far away. Returning home after that first Wimbledon victory, she went out to celebrate at a nightclub in Brisbane, but was told Aboriginals weren't welcome. The Wimbledon champion was still a second-class citizen to some. Goolagong's achievements stack up among the greats of the game. In 1971, 1975, 1976 and 1977, she reached the singles final of every Grand Slam championship in which she competed, winning five of them. She and Martina Hingis are the only players to reach six Australian Open finals in a row, and Goolagong is one of only four players to win three consecutive Australian Open titles, which she achieved between 1974 and 1976. She also won the second of the two Australian Open tournaments held in 1977. Only Court and Serena Williams have won more often in Melbourne. In addition to her two Wimbledon titles, Goolagong was also runner-up at the US Open 4 years in a row between 1973 and 1976. In total, she won 84 career tour singles titles and 53 doubles titles and was ranked number one in the world in April 1976. Incredibly, an admin error meant her ranking points weren't correctly recorded at the time. In fact, her number one ranking wasn't confirmed until 2007, 31 years later. During the 1976 US Open, Yvonne discovered she was pregnant. She played just one more tournament that year, raising eyebrows by competing while she was in the second trimester of her pregnancy. In her cheerfully determined way, Yvonne was still breaking down barriers. Yet arguably, her greatest achievement was still to come. Goolagong arrived at Wimbledon in 1980, having barely played because of injury, and with Chris Evert and Martina Navratilova already beginning to tighten their grip on women's tennis. Goolagong's win over Evert in the final To become the first mother to win at Wimbledon for 66 years was beyond even her dreams. This was a triumph from the unlikeliest of circumstances, a perfect vignette for her whole career. After she stopped playing, Goolagong devoted much of her time helping Indigenous children learn to love sport just as she did. She has inspired generations of Australians, not least current world number one Ashleigh Barty, another immense tennis talent of Indigenous heritage. As Barty said, "I cherish our shared heritage and I'm humbled to walk in her footsteps."